Morning everyone, welcome for today's edition of our mathematics presentation.
Okay, our topic for today's video is about adding fractions and mixed numbers with or without regrouping. Okay, our topic for today's video is about the rules in adding similar and dissimilar fractions. Okay, before we'll go to our exercises, let us first review the rules in adding fraction. Okay, rule number one, to add fractions with the same denominator, add the numerator and bring down the common denominator. Okay, we have the example. So if we look at the two fraction, they have the same denominator, 2 over 6 or 2 6 plus 3 6, so they have both the same denominator, so the rule number one will apply. So according to rule number one, add the numerator and bring down the common denominator. So we add 2 and 3, we have 5, then bring down the common denominator, which is 6. So that's how to apply rule number one. That is applicable when the two denominator are the same or they have similar denominator. Okay, example number 2, 3 fifth plus 1 fifth, so they have also the same denominator of 5. So what you are going to do is add the numerator, 3 plus 1 will have 4, and bring down the common denominator, which is 5. So that is an example for rule number 1. Okay, let's go to rule number 2. Okay, to add fraction with dissimilar or not the same denominator, find the least common denominator. So we will take into an example wherein the two fractions have no common denominator, or their denominator is not the same. So we call it dissimilar fraction. So the rule says, find the least common denominator. What is this least common denominator? So we will identify what is this least common denominator. LCD or least common denominator means the least number that can be divided by two or more number exactly without remainder. Meaning to say that this is the least number that can be divided by the two or more number exactly without remainder. So this is for rule number 2. Okay, how to find for the least common denominator? Since this is the similar problem, and these are common problem for pupils on how to find for the least common denominator. So I will introduce to you a shortcut way of finding the least common denominator. So according to the rule that I have, think of a number that can be divided by two or more denominator exactly without remainder. So when we think of a number, it should be a number that can be divided exactly by the two or more denominator. Okay, what is the rule in finding for that number? Okay, letter A, look at the bigger denominator. So we are going to look at the bigger denominator. See if it can be divided by the other denominator. If it is, then let it be your LCD. So take on example number 1. 3 6 plus 7 12. So the two denominators is 6 and 12. So according to the rule that I give you, so look at the bigger denominator. So we will look at the bigger, which is the bigger denominator. So we have 12. So see if it can be divided by the other denominator. So let us look at the other denominator, which is 6. Can we divide 12 by 6? Yes, we can divide 12 by 6. So according to the rule, if it is divisible, then let it be your LCD. So our LCD will become 12. Let's not look for another number because 12 is already divisible by 6. So let 12 be your LCD. Okay, for example number 2, we have 1/4 plus 3/8. So which is the bigger denominator? We have 8. 8 is divisible by 4. So it can be divided by 4. So why look for another number when your bigger denominator can be divided? So let 8 be your LCD. So in this rule, we have to apply the process of looking into the other denominator. So if it is divisible, then let it be your LCD. Okay, for rule letter B, if the bigger denominator is not divisible, start multiplying the bigger denominator with 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on, until you come up with a number that can be divided by exactly without remainder by the other denominator. So, we will try and apply that to this example. So, we have 3, 10, plus 5, 12. So, as we look at the denominator of the fraction, we have 10 and 12. So, we will look at the bigger denominator, which is 12. 12 cannot be divided by 10. So, according to the rule that I give you, let's start multiplying it by 2, 3, 4, 5, until you come up with a number which can be now be exactly divided by the other denominator. Okay, so 12 cannot be divided, so we multiply it by 2, so we have 24, cannot be. Okay, 12 times 3, 36, still cannot be. 12 times 4, 48, still cannot be divided by 10. So, we have 12 times 5 equals 60. Now, 60, according to the rule of divisibility, numbers that can be divided by 10 are those numbers ending in 0. Okay, so 60 can now be divided by 10. So, we will have 60 as our LCD. So, that's how to find for the LCD. We just simply look at the bigger denominator, then we start by it by multiplying 2, 3, 4, 5, until we will be able to look at a number that can be divided by the other denominator. Okay, rule letter C. Multiplying the two denominator can also be an option in finding for the LCD, but not applicable at all times. So take the case of this example, 4 over 7 or 4, 7 plus 3, 8. So the two denominators are 8 and 7. So we may multiply 8 times 7. So we have 56. So this can also be one way of finding for the LCD. Okay. So, by multiplying the two denominators, you can also have a find for the LCD of the two fraction. Okay, so another example, we have 5, 7 plus 1, 6. So, multiplying the two denominators can also be used as your LCD. So, in this example only, because as what I have said, this is not applicable at all times. Why? Because if you look at the other example, so we have 2 fourth plus 16. If we multiply the two denominators, which is 4 and 10, we will have 40. But if we are to look at it closely, 40 is not the least number. Why? So we will start with rule number 2 that we are using a while ago. So 2/4 plus 2/6. So looking at the bigger denominator, which is 10, multiplying 10 times 2 will give us 20 for the first trial. Now 20 can be divided by 4, so there is no need for us to increase the multiplier. So we multiply it by 2, we have 20. 20 can now be divided by 4, so we will have 20 as our LCD, because this is the least number that can be divided by the other denominator. So it is not always that we will multiply the 2 denominator. It is safer to start multiplying it by 2, 3, 4, and 5, and so on, until we will be able to find for a number that is divisible by the other denominator. Okay, to look for the LCD of the 2 or more fractions, it is safer to start multiplying the bigger denominator by 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on, until we find the number divisible by 2 or more denominator. Example, 5, 8 plus 3, 6. If we multiply the denominator of 8 and 6, we will get 48. So this is the denominator if we have to multiply it directly by the 2 denominator. But if we will start it the other way, by multiplying the bigger denominator by 2, 3, 4, and 5, and so on, we will just be able to have in an LCD of 24. This time, we got only 8 times 2, 16, cannot be, and 8 times 3, we will get 24, and 24 will now be our LCD, because 24 is divisible by 6. So using this one is safer compared to multiplying right away the denominator of the 2 fraction. So this is how we are going to add similar and dissimilar fraction. So similar fraction is just very easy to add, because we simply add the numerator and bring down the common denominator. But in dissimilar fraction, you need to find for the LCD. That's why you have to apply the formula, you have to memorize the rule in adding dissimilar fraction, especially looking for the LCD. So try to memorize the rule in adding dissimilar fraction, and memorize also the steps in looking for the LCD.
Thank you for subscribing my channel. Don't forget to hit the notification bell so that you will be notified for the next videos that I will be uploading. Thank you once again, and God bless us all.